listen.
It's a practice. And the more we do it, the more we are strengthening what's called our prefrontal cortex. So they've done some fabulous, fabulous studies into the brain and its workings. And Dan Siegel, who's a clinical psychologist, talks about his hand model of the brain. And if we look at this part of the brain as our downstairs, how when I talk to kids and I'm talking to them about their brain, I talk about the upstairs brain and the downstairs brain. And this downstairs part wants to keep you safe, and it's very protective. But then we have this upstairs thinking part of the brain, which is our prefrontal cortex right here. And we want those to talk together. So what mindfulness allows us to do is when you're hit with that strong emotion, these two kind of talk to each other. You take a breath, you're able to kind of come to a calm place so that we don't, as Dan Siegel says, flip our lids.
That's okay, I know.
Part of it too is that, you know, this prefrontal part doesn't really start developing until we're almost 3 years old. But it goes and develops until we're in our mid-20s. So even at the earliest ages, if we can help integrate what is, you know, the chaos and the rigidity that our youngest ones have, you know, when they're faced with those strong emotions because they don't know any other way, and help them start to integrate and use their thinking brain. The more we do it, that repetitive practice over and over and over and over again, this part of the brain starts to develop stronger. It's like, you know, a muscle, working a muscle. And it gets stronger and stronger. So we flip our lid and we might get angry and we might hit somebody or we might grab something or we might yell or throw something. So when kids experience that kind of episode, say, ooh, boy, your protective brain was really in charge there. That's okay. You know, to help them understand those strong emotions. And then know that it's okay. Well, what if we took a breath? And then, oh, what if we tried breathing? You know, sometimes just getting down and holding their hands and making that connection with them. And just take some breaths. And then helping them know that, you know, we're making that, you're making your thinking brain a little bit stronger there. And that's working for you.
It's a beautiful day.
And just because a child may have responded well one day, doesn't mean they are going to do it the next day. And if we can accept that and continue to help them to integrate those pieces, because it's a lot of work. It's a lot of work. And be there as that loving, supportive, caring adult. And know that, you know, we get hungry, we're tired, angry, who knows what's going on. And sometimes we can't do it right all the time. And that's okay.